Hello and welcome to this Haas Tip of the Day. In every one of our lathe programs, at some point, we're going to send our turret or our tail stocks or subspindles to some safe or convenient location. We'll do this at the end of our programs or just before a tool change. Now, when doing this, we're going to use a G53 or a G28 command. Understanding how our G53 and our G28 codes work, I mean how they really work, is essential for every CNC lathe machinist and operator. Now, not understanding how these codes work can cost us. It can cost us a lot of cycle time, or it can even give us some unwanted surprises. Well, let's jump right in and take a look at our G53 and our G28 commands for lathes. If you're running a mill, we've made a totally separate video for you because these commands work just slightly differently on a mill. Now my turret, my lathe, is already sitting at machine home. When we're safely positioning our lathe, everything is in relationship to that home position. So it's really important that we understand how this works. When you come in the morning and you press the power up restart button or the zero return single axis keys, the machine slowly homes each and every axis. Now each axis will move until precision home switches are triggered, typically at the back right corner of travel on Haas lathes. Our machine zero position is really useful to us when we're trying to safely position our turret or our tailstock, because no matter what tool or work offsets that we may have entered, home is always home. On our lathes, we need to move our turret up and out of the way each time we do a tool change. Now the trick is to find the perfect spot that can work when changing to or from any tool. We need to be far enough away from the spindle where we can't possibly hit anything, but not so far away that we're wasting valuable time. Here's how we can move our axes one at a time, safely and consistently using a G53 command. The first thing I do is I pull out my finished part and I load up my raw stock. I want to know exactly where my stock is so we can be sure to avoid it when doing a tool change. Then I'm going to jog my turret to a safe position in the X and the Z. Then I'm going to do a tool change, placing my longest tool into the turret. This is the worst case scenario tool. With that tool in the spindle, I'm going to hand jog into a position where I can do a tool change safely. Now I want to be far enough away from the spindle that we don't hit anything, but I don't want to be clean back at home. That would be too far for my tool to retract and come back to. That would be wasting time. Now once we've found this perfect Goldilocks sweet spot for a tool change, we're going to go back to our control and look at our position screen. We want our machine position. This is the distance we're going to be for our tool change from machine home. Now right now on this ST20, our sweet spot was at X minus 5 inches and Z minus 7 inches. At these locations, G53 X minus 5, G53 Z minus 7, I know I can do a tool change and not hit anything. This is a safe tool change position. So how does our machine position correspond to our G53 location? Well, our machine position is our G53 location. They are one and the same. Our G53 home position is always home. It's always that top right corner on this lathe, regardless of any tool or work offsets that we may have inputted into our control. Now this same method, G53, G0, and then the axis zero location, can be used for any machine axis. We've got a tailstock, which is our B axis. If we command a G53, G0, B0, that's gonna send our tailstock back to home. If we've got a Y axis lathe, you can command your Y axis back to the home position by commanding a G53, G0, Y0. Now, a little tip with Y-axis lathes, you almost always have to home your Y-axis before you home your X-axis. The travel gets really tight up towards the X home position, so we require you to send that Y-axis home first prior to homing the X. G53 temporarily calls up our machine coordinate system, temporarily. So if we call up a G53, G0, X0, it's going to send our machine to the X home position only on that line. On the very next line of code, if we're not using a G53, the machine is going to revert back to whatever work coordinate system it happens to have been in, G54 in our case. This is why we need to be careful and call out a G53 on each and every safe positioning line of code. Well, that's it. G53 is pretty straightforward and really useful for positioning that turret before a tool change. If commanding a G53 X0Z0 is like heading straight home after work, then commanding a G28 is more like stopping off for milk on your way home. I'm serious. G28 is a very different code than G53. If we command one or more axis locations on a G28 line, the machine's going to do two things. One, it's going to move to that XZ location in the current coordinate system, like G54, and two, it's going to move to your machine position. So again, your machine is going to stop off for milk on its way home. Let's take a look at our part. Now, on a lathe, you never want to command a G28, G0, X0, or Z0. Now, we're going to do that right now because we need to explain how this code works, but never do it, okay? So, my tool is not going to go home. It's going to go to X0, Z0 in the current work coordinate system, G54 in this case. The tool came in, it came right back out. Had we had raw stock in our chuck instead of this finished part, we would have crashed our machine. So there are lots of ways to crash your machine using a G28 along with an X or a Z value. If you do find a program that is homing your turret using a G28, it'll always be using an incremental move. Okay, so instead of commanding an X value, X0, command a U value. On a lathe, a U is an incremental X move. Instead of commanding a Z0, command a W0. A W is an incremental Z-axis move. In this way, what you're essentially saying is, from where I'm at, move incrementally zero distance, and then go home. Now, if we're just trying to get to home for a certain axis, why stop off for milk? Why not just tell it to go home? That's why I really prefer the G53 method, which is our machine coordinate system. So we need to show you how G28 works so you can go into your programs and change them all to G53s. Now, just because we can send our turret back to machine home doesn't mean that we should. Remember, if you go all the way back to machine home, you might be wasting time. Find some sweet spot right in the middle of your machine travel where you can do a tool change at, and then use a G53 to get you there. Now, if you're running lots of parts, then you want to look at our G200 index on the fly feature. This allows us to actually uncouple the turret while it is moving into a safe tool change position. This can save you a lot of seconds, which will add up hours, right? Which is a lot of dollars saved. So, that's it for this Haas tip of the day. Don't forget to stop and pick up some milk on your way home. And be sure to subscribe to this channel. You don't want to miss what we've got coming up next.